Hello everybody, it's Raghavesh here. In this video, I am going to discuss about Zener as a voltage regulator. As you are aware, Zener is one of the special purpose device diode which is used as a voltage regulators. And also you must be knowing that the Zener is generally connected the reverse bias. In a forward bias, it's going to work as a normal diode. Now, I have taken one diode 1N5255 and I connected with the series resistor, and we need to have some calculation on that, which you may study in your theory portions and all. So, there is a series resistor and you must have some unregulated power supply. That means what should be your minimum value and what should be your maximum value. As per the data sheet, 1N5255 is nothing but it's a Zener diode, which is going to output 28.5 volt. If you are going to design a 5 volt regulator or maybe a 9 volt, you have to choose a proper diode path number. Okay. And then you have to use that diode path number to get the simulation results. The purpose of this exercise now to make you understand what is the meaning of line regulation. If you look at this diagram, we have a power supply. In real time cases, it's not going to be power supply. It could be a rectifier with the filter. Rectifier and filter alone is not going to provide us a constant DC voltage. The voltage is going to have some kind of ripple which need to be eliminated, or in other words, that kind of power supply called as an unregulated power supply. We need to have a regulated power supply. So what we are going to use this Zener diode as a voltage regulator. If your power supply is ranged from, let us say, from 7 to 10 volt, okay, whereas you want to get only 5 volt, in that case you have to choose a 5 volt Zener. So the Zener diode is going to act as a regulator. Okay. In this case, I am going to demonstrate to you the voltage range which I am going to assume from here, like 32 volt to 100 volt, and as I told you earlier, this is going to be 28 volt Zener. I just chosen again 285 ohms to make sure that the current is about 100 milliamps. Okay. Now you need to find out actually the series resistance to have a proper operation of Zener diode. There are a lot of websites are there, like a simple one like Zener calculator. Just provide what is the maximum input voltage and what is the minimum input voltage and what's supposed to be your Zener voltage. The output voltage is nothing but your Zener voltage. And then load current and just click and calculate. You will get the resistance value. Okay. So this is the resistance value which you are going to use it as a series resistance. Okay. So the resistance value given as a 32 ohms, let us say. Okay, so you have a series resistance and the Zener diode. This is the regulator circuit and this is my load resistor. Okay, now if I want to know the the Zener, how it works or how it regulates, first we need to do two kind of testing. One is called as a line regulation, another one is like load regulation. What does it refers? Line regulation means we assume that our load is fixed, whereas there is a possibility of the voltage on the input side is going to keep changing, which most of the cases it happens. Okay. How this Zener is going to respond? Or there is something called load regulation. That means if you are going to get a source from maybe let us say constant battery, it could be like a car battery or things like that, the fixed source. Whereas load may have a nature of changing nature. So how the Zener is going to provide the constant voltage. Okay. So this is what the two kind of regulation. In this video, I am going to discuss only about the line regulation. Load regulation you have to explore on your own. Now, once you have done the circuit in OrCAD, that means you are going to place the components and connect, and battery source, and provide again a marker, which I told you, you can get it from the place marker and VCC. This you can place it and then you can rename it as a VK, voltage in the cathode, or even I can say as a VL, both are same. That means you can see here, voltage across the Zener is going to be voltage across the load. Okay. So, I just named as a VK. And simulation setting. As I told, you have to create a new simulation profile, but I am just using the same project. So, I am just showing you to how to edit the previous simulation setting from my video 2. In the simulation setting, we need to change this voltage source from 32 volt up to 100 volt. Why up to 100 volt? As I told you earlier, we are going to get the characteristics of Zener for the wide input voltage ranges, how it is going to regulate. Okay. So, for that, we are changing the voltage from 32 to 100. Why again 32? As per the Zener design as a thumb rule, if the Zener is 28.5 volt, you have to feed at least, you know, 2 volt extra. So, I am just feeding even 3 volt extra. Okay. So, I have chosen as a 32 as a start value and end value is 100. I am going to increment in steps of 1. So, what is the power supply name? The power supply name is V1. So, I am giving as a V1. We have only one power supply. So, I am just trying to do a primary sweep on that. I am trying to change the value during the simulation. And I say OK and I just simulate now. After simulation, what we are going to do? We are going to plot the voltage on the x-axis and the current on the y-axis. Please understand, we are going to plot the voltage across the Zener. If you know how good the Zener is going to regulate the voltage, if the Zener is not regulating properly, means you can make it out from the curve, it won't be as, let us say, like a sleeping line. There will be a slanting line. And also you can calculate the start and end values of the voltage and you can find out the percentage of regulation. Okay, that is also possible. Now the simulation is ready. Now I am going to plot on x-axis a VZ or VL. Right now I named it as a VK. Okay. So first plot axis setting, axis variable V of K. So I say OK. And you can see here 28.05 to 28.65 only the variation, you know, from the voltage from 32 to 100. This is the voltage across the Zener. And what happens to the current? That means current through the load we want to measure, right? I of R1. Okay. Current in R1. Say OK. So you can see these are changes. The voltage is changing from 28 and it's up to, let us say, 28.7. 0.7 voltage is only the variation and you can see the current also, it goes like from about 99 to 101 milliamps. Okay. That means it's not 100% perfect regulation. We expect a straight line, something like that. Okay. Which is possible in a very, you know, rare cases. Okay. Since I want to show you clearly the variation, I given the voltage ranges from 32 to 100. Even if you choose the lesser voltage, let us say from 30, you may get a straight line. Okay. But there is not a straight line. It has a variation, but which is not able to observe within the simulation window. Okay. Now, this is what you can learn from this exercise. That means our Zener is doing the perfect regulation. Even if the voltage is going up to 100 volt, as you can see here, this is a maximum 100 volt and it is providing us 28.7 as output voltage. So, this is how the Zener is going to regulate the voltage and this is how you can test this circuit in our OrCAD. Okay, in this video, we learned how to construct a simple Zener based regulator circuit and also how to measure the voltage across the load for the various input voltages, that means from the wide range from 32 to 100. This voltage is chosen based on the Zener voltage. If your Zener is going to be lesser voltage, you have to choose appropriately here. Mostly we won't use the battery here. As I told you, this may be the input from the power supply section. Okay, it could be the transformer, rectifier, and then filter section. You need to calculate the series resistance and you need to choose the proper Zener voltage. Hope you understood from this video about Zener as a voltage regulator. Thanks for watching the video.